These workflow tips in Adobe Illustrator are going to blow your designer socks right off. They're going to make your life a whole lot easier and speed up your workflow. So let's jump right into today's video. Learn more about the awesome workflow tool Milanote later in today's video, and also how to sign up for free with a no time limit period attached. The first one relates to the tabs that you can see on the left of my screen. These are of course just panels taken from the window drop-down menu that I find personally useful in my workflow. But there is a hack or a simple kind of setup preference that I like to use. When you have the desired panels you find useful to your workflow, you can click and drag them out so each panel has its relevant name shown on the panel itself. Now this helps because you don't have to memorize every single symbol or icon for each panel. And in the past, I did waste a lot of time trying to find the right tab, but this way you just read the name and it's really straightforward. But let's take a look at the second tip in today's video. So as you can see here, we have three shapes stacked on top of each other. Now we could use the layers panel to select objects behind, or maybe even a keyboard shortcut. But one of the really neat things that I like to use is to find the selection tool and then hold down the command or the control key and you will see your cursor change. Click once and we select the next object beneath, and then another click selects the object below that one. This is great for these designs that have a lot of layers and things overlapping, where you might want to click to change objects below something else. So yeah, again, just hold down the command or the control key and then click to select things below. So here's a nifty time-saving trick with the shift key. So come into the color panel and then hover over the color bar found here. Click while holding down the shift key and then you can toggle the color modes from CMYK, HSB, grayscale, and also back to RGB. This is obviously a nice little time-saving trick and a good addition to your bag of workflow tricks. So do you know about global edits? This only works on single shapes or grouped objects. And so for my selection here, I press Command G, or that would be Control G on Windows to group them together. Then I duplicate the asset by holding down the Alt Option key. If I select one of them and head into the Global Start Edit, you'll notice some new bounding boxes around my grouped objects. So whatever I do to one of these objects, Illustrator will automatically do the exact same thing to the other assets. So adding gradients, resizing, changing color, you name it, whatever happens to one will be copied over to the other objects. This is great for designs that maybe have patterns or illustrations with lots of similar objects like leaves or clouds. It's just another process that saves you time, which is crucial when it comes to designing something for a client. Time is money, as they say. But let's move on to the next workflow tip in today's tutorial. Now this is a personal favorite of mine, and many of you will know this already, but there are also going to be people who still need to learn it. When we're working on text, we often want to kern that text, i.e. adjust the space between each letter. The character window does offer tracking, but we cannot move individual letters around. So instead, place your cursor between two characters while having the text tool activated. Click once and then hold down the Alt or the Option key and nudge to the left and to the right using your arrow keys on your keyboard. This saves us from having to outline the text when manually kerning things. And this one's great for logotype, but also headings for things like brochures or poster designs. It's a trick that I really do use every single day in my workflow. And to demonstrate the next tip, I have here a quick vector design that I made from the three circles that you saw earlier. Now, if we open up the graphic styles tab, you will notice a few default options here, but we can add our own graphic styles in this box. Illustrator is going to save the color, the gradient, the effects, the stroke settings of your object. It's useful for when you want to make an object that is exactly the same in appearance as something else already on your design. And the time-saving upshot of this should be pretty obvious. The defaults aren't that great, but of course, we can build our own library relevant to our projects and our workflows. It's also possible to edit the name of each style by double-clicking them right here. And then, let's take a look at another keyboard shortcut that I often use on complex designs. Often, when we are working on vast illustrations or designs with lots of different anchor points, the anchor points themselves can get in the way of our view, which, let's face it, that can be really annoying. So just press Command or Control H, that's H for hotel, and then the anchor points are hidden. Now you can press the same shortcut to reveal them once again. It's just a nice way to take a step back, review your work without anything obscuring it. So today's video is sponsored by Milanote. Now I've been a firm advocate of Milanote for 3 years, and if you've been subscribed to my channel for a while, you will know that Milanote is a bit different to traditional software. Now it's more like working on the wall, so to speak, in a creative studio. It allows you to map out your projects, collect all of your ideas and inspiration in one convenient place, and it also allows you to collaborate with your colleagues or your clients in real time. So I've been using Milanote for the past 3 years to keep my creative projects organized, and this awesome tool is available for free with no time limit. So if you haven't done already, sign up for free using the link in the description box below and start to streamline your graphic design workflow today. But if you want to learn more about graphic design or Adobe Illustrator, do click a video on screen. And until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.